Shipwreck Scuba Gear in the Ocean Floor coming to the Thomas Crane Public Library in April when representatives from the Stellwagen Bank National Marine Sanctuary visit on April 23rd from 10 a.m. to noon in the Children's Wing of the Thomas Crane Public Library. And we're being joined now by representatives of Stellwagen Bank, Anne-Marie Runfola, who's a volunteer program coordinator, and volunteers Caitlyn Fitzmaurice and McKenzie Welch. Thank you all for joining us here today.
You're welcome.
Anne-Marie, we'll start with you. What exactly is the Stellwagen Bank National Marine Sanctuary?
Well, it's like a big national park in the open ocean. It's a wild ocean place right in our backyard here in Massachusetts. And there are 14 such national marine sanctuaries around the country. We have the only one in New England right here. And it's a line drawn on the map around a place that's been historically important for fishing and a feeding area for whales and seabirds, fish, all kinds of wildlife for hundreds of years. And so that area is a protected area that's under NOAA, National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration.
It goes from Gloucester down to Cape Cod, and it's very wide as well. I mean, how big is it and where exactly is it from Quincy per se?
So it's the size of Rhode Island. It's huge, 842 square miles, and it's close to Cape Ann and Cape Cod, just about 3 miles off of both of those points is where the boundary starts. And from Boston, since we're in such a deep harbor, it's about, goes so far into the harbor, it's about 23 miles to get into the sanctuary proper.
Now, at the Marine Sanctuary, volunteers and staff go out there and do what? Do research? Looking for marine life, sea life, what exactly?
Yeah, so our mandate is to protect the marine mammals, the biodiversity, and the maritime heritage of the sanctuary while facilitating compatible use. So we have research programs going on so that all of our decisions, management policy decisions, are based on data. We do education and outreach as well. And we go out into the sanctuary when we can afford it. We raise funds to go out there and we study the marine mammals. We study ocean noise, acoustics. We have a seabird research program, and some of that is with volunteers, with citizen scientists. It's very important what they're eating, so we need to study that. So we have a sandlance study going on with the USGS. We work with lots of other institutions. This area has so many scientific institutions and universities, so we work with them, partner with them on all kinds of other studies.
Now, with all the data collected, what exactly is done with that data? Like you said, it goes to universities and other research laboratories?
Yeah, we use it to understand things like where the whales are feeding and where all the ships are coming through, and how do we make sure that the ships can avoid where the whales are, since ship strikes are a problem and we'd like to minimize that as much as possible. So we use data to figure out how to shift the shipping lane so that the ships could still get in time to get their goods in while avoiding the areas where the whales feed the most. So we share the data nationally and internationally with universities, other organizations, to help us understand the whole ecosystem out there and how we can protect it.
Now, talk about the outreach that you do. Obviously, you come into the library, but you go to a lot of different places, schools, libraries, wherever, to talk about the Marine Sanctuary.
Yeah, we have a number of programs. We have a very active education program. There's a Massasoit Community College course, which will eventually be online. There's a cell phone tour. There are exhibits in various places from the New England Aquarium, Maritime Gloucester, all up and down the coast. We have volunteers help us run education and outreach activities. We go to festivals, fairs. We try and have a float in the Scituate St. Patrick's Day Parade. You name it, we try and get out there and do it in a variety of ways.
Now, you mentioned as well, it goes from Gloucester and the Cape Cod. That's a pretty big area to cover. How do you go about doing all that for all the research and the outreach to cover that large area?
Yeah, it's a lot of work. And so the volunteer program has been really key in helping us get the word out to more places and to partner with more organizations. And we also work with other organizations to train their staff and volunteers and give them educational kits, activity guides, and help train them so that they'll run activities on our behalf that also meet with their missions. So then we have even more people working on behalf of the sanctuary and getting the word out. So that's been really powerful.
We have a couple of volunteers here with us today. We'll introduce them again, Caitlyn Fitzmaurice and McKenzie Welch. Caitlyn, talk about exactly what you do as a volunteer at the Marine Sanctuary.
I've been volunteering with the sanctuary for the past 4 years, and I started out working with mostly kids programs and the Child Sanctuary events, and I earned my Girl Scout Gold Award, which is the highest award in Girl Scouting, by working with Anne-Marie and putting together an event for kids to come to and their families to learn more about marine life. And I recently started working with the Seabird program.
Okay, that's pretty cool. And McKenzie, how about you? What do you do there as a volunteer?
I work there with education outreach as well. I will be helping out with all the programs they're having. I've only been a volunteer for a few months now. But also my main goal will be social media, trying to make sure the Facebook and Twitter is sort of a more hip spot to go to.
Excellent. Now, how did you find out about the volunteer program and why did you decide to volunteer?
I found out about it because at my high school we have this internship class where we're able to get an internship at the career of our choice, and I chose marine biology because I've always been interested. And my teacher found out to the Stellwagen bank, and I was like, oh yeah, this looks really awesome. And then after looking at all the projects they did, I knew that this was going to help me out, and it looked like a lot of fun.
Caitlyn, how about you? How'd you find out, and why are you volunteering?
I met Anne-Marie at the library in Scituate where I was volunteering for a while.
And why do you like volunteering so much at the sanctuary?
Well, I'm working on a major in marine biology currently, so.
Excellent. And are there a lot of other volunteers? I'm obviously looking for more volunteers as well, Anne-Marie, at any time?
Always, always. They should get in touch. If they go to our website, which is stellwagen.noaa.gov, stellwagen.noaa.gov, and they go to get involved, there's a volunteer section, and my contact information is all there.
All right, well, hopefully you can get some more volunteers at the Quincy Thomas Crane Public Library on April 23rd. Talk about what's going to be happening there. It's open to children, families, all ages are welcome to come.
That's right. All ages are welcome to come. We recommend ages 4 to 12. The activities are most appropriate, but it's fun for the adults to see as well, because a lot of them don't know a lot about the Maritime Heritage Program in particular, which is our shipwrecks in our case. So we have maritime archaeologists on our staff. They're divers, and they use all kinds of cool technology, like remote-operated vehicles, to image the ocean floor and look for and identify shipwrecks. So the kids and their families will learn about that by becoming underwater detectives with us, and they'll use clues to learn about what shipwreck is down on the ocean floor and a little bit more about what kind of ship that was, who might have been on board, all the things that our archaeologists do as scientists every day. There'll be a sonar matching game where they have to look at images of the shipwreck from the ocean floor, just like our scientists do, and match it up with historical illustrations or photographs of those shipwrecks and try and put the clues together just like our archaeologists do.
A lot of hands-on things to do, and
yes.
You're wearing something right now that people will be able to try on.
That's
about
right.
That.
Yeah, so we're in. McKenzie, do you want to talk about this?
Sure.
What are we wearing?
Basically, these are called survival suits, and they're basically your best friend when the ship starts to go down, because it will keep you afloat the entire time. It will keep you super warm, and pretty much. And also, there's going to be a relay race during the event, and to see who can get in this suit the fastest, because let's be real, this is a struggle to get into.
As we talk about getting into it before the shoot here,
yeah.
Like you said, it wasn't an easy thing just to jump in and jump out.
Yeah, you have to lie down, have someone help you up, zip, and then zipping up at sea, doesn't even, trying to move is a struggle.
I assume this must be one of the most popular things for kids and for parents as well, trying to get in and out and trying to beat their son or daughter to get in out of the survival suit, so it's kind of a cool thing. And Caitlin, what are you demonstrating for us here tonight?
I have my goggles and snorkel, and the kids can try this on during the shipwreck mapping activity where they get to pretend to be divers and dive down and explore a shipwreck.
So there's going to be a lot to happen. Again, all ages, families are welcome. Is registration required, or is it just kind of a walk right in thing?
Walk right in. You can try one activity, or you can stay and try them all multiple times and stay with us the whole time. It's free to the public.
Now, one of the things you may have mentioned was there's a scavenger hunt that's on the South Shore. Talk a little about that. So when people leave on April 23rd, they can then do a scavenger hunt if they want to as well.
Yes, actually outside our office, the South Shore Quest is a guidebook that has scavenger hunts all over the South Shore. And for a couple years in a row, we've been part of that. And so they can get a South Shore Quest book, and you can find that at South Shore Quest. I think it's southshorequest.org, but just Google South Shore Quest, and you'll find our scavenger hunt. You'll learn about the sanctuary and the work that we do and things like the weather station that we have on our building and about our research vessel and other things about us in Scituate.
For more information about this program or any other program at the Thomas Crane Public Library, visit thomascranelibrary.org.